So here we are back in our master storyboard template here. And let's say now you want to add a company logo to your storyboard, which would make it very attractive, obviously, to the end user. So again, we're going to do the same thing as we did before. We're going to add another section. So I select an area here. I'm just going to drag it out here. And let's say I want to make my logo maybe that size right there. And I say add a section. And I'm just going to make it white so it blends in nicely with the background this time. So I'm going to click on the OK. And I've got a section 5 here. Now we need to format this. So we point at it, we hit the right mouse button, and we go to Format Shape. And in here, under the Fill option, you go to the Picture or Text Fill, this one right here. And it's going to give you the opportunity to import your logo from a file. So I click on the file here, and I'm just going to go here, and I'm going to go find my logo that we're going to use in this example here. I have it in this folder here. This is acsstoryboard.gif, and it places it right in there for me. You can see it getting put in here, and then we can just close out of this, and then we can size this anyway, so it's not particularly in the right spot. You can move it around, you can size it any way that you like here. By dragging and dropping it, you can make this a little bit bigger if you wanted, so that it might lined up with the area below, and then maybe move the picture over a little bit to correspond with that there. Okay, so now we have that there. Now you'll notice the text is still in the background there. You can see it underneath it. So I want to edit this text, which is behind the picture. I just highlight that and delete it. And now we've got a nice clean logo here. I'm also going to fix the typo I made down here earlier on there. And now we're ready to save it again. So again, the usual thing, you go to the file, you go to Save As, be sure it's going into the Applied Computer Services Templates folder. It's called storyboard.xtlm, and it's an Excel macro-enabled template. If it's not, be sure and change it to that before you save it. Click on the Save, and it will say, do you want to replace it? Say yes, and then I can close out of this, and I'm back on my sample. I hit the right button. I go to the storyboard. It's going to generate all of the items. Again, I'd have to fill in the data here. It's a brand new one here. I go to the storyboard. There's my logo. I hit the play. And of course, the logo stays there as you're working through each of the steps in your process.